happened to drop in, and just in time for a song.
Gleaming down through the gates, watch the knights of Fifth Kate, all the lights that smothers the sun. I can tell by the moon you'll be joining me soon as a guest in my fortress of fun. And I can't wait to see you and once again free you, release from your humorous hair. Someday I will replace that big frown on your face with a smile and a murderous glare. We are two of a kind, violent, unsound of mind. You're the yin to my yang, can't you see? And if I were to leave, you would crumble and
what is up, all you comic book fans of Comic Book Village, coming to you with another haul video. This is my 206th sixth haul video for January 8, 2020. I know today's technically the 9th, but this is my haul for the 8th. I did pick up my books late yesterday afternoon. Like I said in one of my videos, that they were late, so I didn't get to pick them up until later on in the afternoon. So today, on the which is the 9th, this is Thursday morning, I decided to go and do my video. And it was a pretty good size day today. Here we go for Mr. Perry. Was a decent haul today for my new comic books. Alright, let's go ahead and get started. They didn't give me a bag today. They gave the... My haul was kind of big. They gave me the diamond box. So, I'll be pulling them out of the diamond box here. And I'll go through them. And just like I tell y'all, I'll let you know if it was pre-ordered or if it was just something that I asked them to pull for me. Alright. Now, I asked them to pull me these. And it was kind of my fault too. I should have checked while I was there. I asked for these in the 40th anniversary covers, but this isn't. This is the Dawn of X cover or whatever. This is Fallen issue number 5. Fallen Angels issue number 5. That three books this week came out with a 40th anniversary cover. And the New Mutants number 5. This is also the Dawn of X. I did want the 40th, they gave me those, and they didn't give me the 40th. I called them back after I figured it out, and they said that they didn't get them. They did get one, because I do have one in here. And like I said, they messed up these books. So like I said, that was pre-ordered. I mean, those I had them pulled for me. So this is pre-order right here. Avengers of Vampirella number 4. This is the... So let me scratch their butt. This is the Perillo cover. The Lucio Perillo. Let's flip through real quick for y'all. Let y'all see what's going on inside. Wow, that's pretty cool. So, ton of covers for Vampirella, of course. That was issue number... that was the A cover. Here is the B cover right here. Nice looking cover here. This one sold out quick at Midtown. So I did pick up a second copy. Well, since they were behind on their pool, what they did, they pulled all their, you know, I guess their important subscribers, which I'm one of them. So they had my books ready. The thing is, though, I didn't pre-order. These were pre-order, 1, 2, 3, 4. I pre-ordered these, but when I saw how the covers looked like actually live or whatever, I told me, can I get another copy of that one? This one, they said they had to wait till they finished pulling everybody. To see if they were going to have anything left to make it to the wall. And they did. They called me last night and they told me that they were able to give me another copy of the Perillo and that one. So, and they just threw it in my box, which I'm cool with it. And this right here is the C cover. Nice looking cover right there. Like I said, pre-order. I pre-ordered all of those. And then, of course, you know how the villain do. The villain always gets that cosplay cover. Yeah, sure. Mr. Cosplay. So those are the Vampirellas. Like I said, pre-order this right here. This, of course, I asked them to pull for me. Oh, man, these are all jacked up. I guess I'll do these next then. Because there's one missing from that one. I don't know where it's at. I'll find it. I hate showing them not together if I got two. This is Symbiote Spider-Man Alien Reality. First issue was pretty good. So, I'm not too sure how many issues this is going to be. I want to say it's a mini-series. But I'm not too sure on how long the mini-series, how many issues or whatever. That's nice. Right there. So, there was about three or four covers for that one, maybe more. I only picked up A, and I believe this is the B. Oh, no, this is a C. According to this, it's a C. See, two is issue number 2, 3, and volume 1. The last number is the volume 1. So this is C. This is a C cover. Just in case, for y'all who don't really understand how you can tell off the barcode, that's how you can tell. It's, there's a new Stranger Things miniseries 1. This is number 1 of 4. This is the B cover. I only like the B cover. So, I wasn't feeling the A or the C either. So, I only picked up the B cover. She's jacked up. Can't wait to read that one. Alright, let's see what's next. Alrighty. This was pre-order right here. This is Supergirl number 38. Still with the Batgirl who laughs. Supergirl who laughs. I don't know why I said Batgirl. Let me show you the inside a little bit. Oh, somebody's got her invited to. She almost looks like Gene Simmons there. So, of course, had to get that nice looking Derek 2 B cover. Almost looks like Art Germ. Almost looks like the work of Art Germ. Yes, indeedy, feed the needy. It sure does. Put those right there. Let's see. Oh, yeah, the first issue was good. This is the second issue right here. The Rise of Kylo Ren. And this is a Clayton Crane cover. I'm surprised I didn't pick up two. I don't know why I didn't pick up two. Hopefully when I go back next week, they should have some more. I might pick up another one. Great interior artwork as well. Beautiful. Look at that. Can't wait to read that one. Oh, and I'm supporting that the Harley Quinn today. Did I move the... No, it's behind it. I was like, what did I do with the Star Wars? But it's behind it. It's behind it there. Alright, let's see. Alrighty. Of course, this was pre-order right here as well. Star number 1. This is the A cover. I forgot who did this one. Just flipped through it. I didn't even flip through it while I was at the shop. I just saw it and moved on. The Infinity Stones. Soul, Mind, Space, Power, Time, and Reality Stone. 1-6 stones. So, of course, there's supposed to be a new stone in here. Not a new one, but I mean, she's got a stone apparently. Or she's just getting a stone, one of the two. Oh, look at that. Ali. Wow. Oh, come on. Oh, it's Loki. Loki's in here. Cool. Interior artwork. Can't wait to read that one. And then, of course, I also got another book coming in from another online store. But this is Star. This is the J.Scott. Can't go wrong with the J.Scott. Mm-mm. And, of course, you know the villain. Got two of them J.Scotts. Yes, sir. And this was pre-ordered as well. The Plot, number 4. This has been a really good read as well. Flip through it for y'all. Check out the interior artwork. It's pretty cool. Interior artwork's alright for the storyline. So that is the Plot, number 4. And y'all, this is also pre-order right here. This is Moonshine, number 15. Yes, sir. Only one book came out for issue 15. I've really been enjoying this. They took a long break, though. Took a long hiatus. I want to say about a five-month break between the last book, whatever. What was the last book that came out? Was it 12? 11 or 12 or 13? I forgot what 13, maybe. I don't know. Forgot, but they took a long break before they put out there. And this is all, let's see, this is pre-order. Gotta find the other ones. Jesus Christ, man, that's the thing about these guys. They at the counter, they scan them, and it's some, what they do is that they scan them and they move them, and sometimes the computer for some reason it doesn't scan it right. They go three more, then they look at the thing and they realize they didn't scan something, so they go back to the book and scan it. So they put, when I take them from the back counter, from the back of the shop to the front of the shop where the cash register at, I have them in line the way I want to have them, and then they mess them up at the damn counter because, you know, they don't pay attention to their scanning. But anyway, Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. This is pre-order as well. Look at that. Gonna show you a little of the interior. Boom, she's playing the sword or somebody. Boom, that's a little bit of the inside right there. Of course, you know how the villain do. There's a cosplay cover, a photo cover. Some people call, well, this one is actually listed as photo, and the other one on the Elvira, on the Vampirella, those are listed as cosplay. Here's another pre-order right here. The first book was awesome, totally awesome, and this is based on a true story. It is The Butcher of Paris, number 2, based, it even says right there, based on a true story. First one was good. Really enjoyed that first one. Uh-oh, we're doing a burlesque show or whatever you call that. That hichi kichi ya 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 crap. Uh-oh, she's giving table dances to an old man. She's about to get rich. So that has been a good read right there. This was also pre-ordered right here. I've been enjoying this one. This is Battle Pug, number 5. This is the B cover. Just fooled all over. At first, I thought it was Christmas lights. When I saw it on the Midtown website when they first, because, you know, the picture's only so big, I said, is he tangled up in Christmas lights? But no. It's actual, like, barbed wire around him. And then it's like, I guess, like, it's electrocuting him. Like, those are supposed to be shock, I guess. Shock, lightning bolt or whatever, electricity. But this has been, oh, look at that. A winged, look like a winged penguin, saber-tooth, rat, unicorn. That's what it looks like to me. Now, these are on my pull list. I don't have to pre-order these. These are, well, it's on my pull list. So they pull for me every time it comes out. So, still sticking with it. The Immortal Hulk, number 29. Beautiful Alex Ross cover. Let's flip through it real quick. See what we got going on here. go to the last page, see what's going on. Eat or be eaten. And that's the next issue. Look at that nice looking Alex Ross cover right there. Yes, sir. This picture right here, he looks like a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle Spider-Man, even though it's supposed to be the Hulk. Doesn't he look like his face? Look like a, one of the turtles. So that is the A cover. Here's the Marvel X cover. It's got some crazy long leg arms on him. And then, of course, the way my pool thing is set up is... What the hell? Oh, man. I could end up getting two of these. I didn't even know that. Gee, Nellis. This is supposed to be... So, I got two copies of second printing number 26. I like the way the pencil artwork looks. Well, I got two. Yeah, I was only supposed to get one, but I got two. And then, of course, second printing of number 27. Like I said, I'm getting everything of the Immortal Hulk. The regular one through, and I got second, third, fourth printings as well. Alrighty. See, now here's another one with strictly cover by two. I don't get this one anymore. This is Excalibur number 5C, and this is the 40th. Dark Phoenix anniversary. They did get this one in, so they did give me this one. And I, like I said, I didn't notice till I got home that the other two covers weren't the right covers. So I was kind of pissed off about that. I called back to the shop and I told them, and they said let me look, and they said they didn't get the 40th anniversary on the New Mutants and Fallen Angel, whatever. But then they were both beautiful covers too, man. I wish they would have had them. Yes, sir. And here we go. This is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles number 101. Let's see what's going on in there. She ball headed. Okay, now we're just checking it out. There is issue. I said that's the A cover, and here is the Eastman B cover right there. Always love the Eastman art. To me, Eastman is the Turtles. And then, of course, I got that 1 in 10 right here. They give it to me for cover price. Tell your children not to look my way. Tell your children not to hear my words. What to be, what to say, brother. Sorry about that, guys. Buddy of mine was calling me. I'm gonna have to call him back. I will call him back. Real quick. Just let me finish up this video. And I'll be done. Alright. This was pre-order right here. This was pre-order. This is Venom number 22. Venom Island Part 2. Yes, sir. And I did get two copies of the A cover. Then I really like that B cover right there. I got two copies of this one too. Two copies of the B cover. Just flip through it real quick for y'all. See what's going on. Ooh. Like the Carnage. Like the Carnage symbiote. Yep, was a little piece of the Carnage. Wow, can't wait to read that one. Yes, sir. And then this one I had them pull for me. This is, I think we're getting to what they just pulled for me now, what I put on my list that I send them every week. Dying is Easy. This is the B cover. I like the B cover up between the both of them. Now, there was a C incentive cover, which was a black and white of that one. So I don't even think they got it. I didn't see it there. And then Ghost Rider number 4. Yes, sir. Oh, wow. That's a wicked looking picture right there. Ooh, he's out now. Let's go check it out in the back, see what's going on. Hmm. Can't wait to read that bad boy, yes sir. And then this is Ghost Spider number 6 right here. I believe there's only one cover for this issue as well this week. And this one right here, got, man, I really enjoyed this. I haven't seen too many people on their videos, but I've been enjoying this one. Gotham City Monsters number 5. Monster against monster. Look at that. Looks like the old, which if you're old enough, you remember the Screamy Memes that used to come on Saturday mornings or Saturday nights or Friday nights. They got the old Dracula, Frankenstein, Mummy, and Werewolf against the new monsters. Oh. But all I know is this interior art is awesome. Let me show you this picture. Look at that. Gotham City Monsters. Can't wait to read that one as well. Still got a few more, guys. This was, had them pull for me. This is Hawkman number 20, I believe. Yes, sir. This is the B cover. This had got slow and stale for a while, but I just stayed with it. Now it's actually pretty good. It is actually pretty good now. Where is the other picture at? Oh, there he is. Doom. Dame's big. So, let me get these out of there real fast. So, this was a last-minute pickup. I put it on my list because I saw Jim from Jim Comics. Talking about the first appearance in here, her first full appearance in Miss Marvel. I forgot who he said, who she said it was. I guess her. Her name's up there. What is it? Storm. Yeah, Storm Ranger. That's who it was. Her first full appearance, Storm Ranger, in there. So that was a last, like a last minute add on. Right there. Alrighty. Of course, this was there too. This is a one shot, the In Miles Morales, number 1. Dude, that, he's old right here. This guy has an old beard. If that is him when he's older. And boom, got two of the A covers. I really like that cover. So I had him pull me two of the A covers. The B cover looks pretty cool too, but I only picked up the A cover on this one shot. Can't wait to read. I know some people were saying if Billy Morales will be in here, I guess grown up or whatever. Well, soon to find out. We'll find out when I read it. Okay. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oblivion Song, I've been enjoying this since day one. I know a lot of people enjoy this Oblivion Song. This has been a real good read as well. So, Oblivion Song number 23 came out today. And then, oh yeah, this is the Power Rangers Turtles crossover. This is issue number 2. And this is also the F.O.C. cover, the final order cutoff. So this one was, I ended up having to give me 2 of them. That is a nice looking cover for that. And then, of course, let's see, this right here. This is Catwoman. This is a J. Scott Campbell. I've been on this since day one. And then, of course, I did get that Marvel X cover as well. But J. Scott Campbell, you cannot pass up his covers, even if you're not collecting Catwoman, even if you're not getting it. I mean, not Catwoman, excuse me, what am I saying? Black Cat, Jesus Christ. I was thinking of Catwoman because I was the next one. This is Catwoman, number 19. This is the B cover. I only picked up the B cover. A cover looked okay, but had to get this B cover. Yes, sir, look at that. Boom. That is a nice looking B cover. Let me get these off. Almost there, guys, almost there. This is the new one from Image, The Clock. Can't wait to read this one. See what this one was about. Badass, I like that one, yes sir. And then this was also a number one from the Hill House, from Joe Hill. This is the Black Label. Daphne Barnes, number one, came out today. I mean, well, yesterday. Keep saying today. Pretty cool. Well, that looked pretty cool. So that is the A cover, and I did pick up that B cover as well, right there, of that number one. And here's another one from Jonah Hill as well. This is Dollhouse Family number 3. This is that wicked looking B cover. Look at that girl. She looks totally possessed. She looks crazy. And this has been really, really cool too. There you go. So that's Dollhouse Family number 3. And then let's see. Okay. Oh, this is Amazing Spider-Man number 37. This is a Marvel X cover. I thought it was better than the B cover. The A cover. So I picked up this one only. That's Amazing Spider-Man number 37. Alrighty. Alright. Okay, here's my Young Justice number 12. This is the A cover right here. Assault on Star Labs. I thought I heard somebody mention something about Naomi in this thing. Ooh! Young Justice Lost in the Multiverse. Come with me, Superboy. They call me Warlord. I guess it's first appearance of Warlord in here. Pretty cool. Can't wait to read that one. And then, of course, everybody knows about this one. This is my last one. Sorry, guys, I think I hit the camera. Batman 86. Got two copies right here. Yes, sir, the A cover. And then, of course, got two copies of that Matina B cover right there. Nice looking B cover. And then this was supposed to be first appearance of Teeth and Dentist, Mr. Teeth and Mr. Cavity. but everybody knows this because this has been floating out the past couple of days on the, for people to pick up this Batman issue due to the, of course, it was going to have a new writer and then the first appearances that were coming out on there. Let me get these off. These are kind of thick already. And let's see. What do we got? Let me get you a cover pick of the week, guys. I got to get you that cover pick of the week. That was a nice cover. Let's see. Oh, you know what? Let me move this one over here. Because that might be that just might be my cover of the week. Oh, oh, that's a nice cover too. Oh, that was a nice cover right there. You know what? That is going to be my cover of the week. The Power Rangers Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle mashup crossover number 2. The F.O.C. cover. The Final Order cutoff. Nice cover right there, guys. Alrighty, guys. That is my 206th comic book haul for January. This is January 8th haul, but it's actually the 9th for 2020. let me know what you think. Was there any books that y'all picked up that I didn't? Which I don't think so, but just in case there was, let me know. Leave comments or whatever, and I have a bunch of stuff on order, but nothing's coming in, I don't think, anytime soon. So, until then, I probably won't have another video until next Wednesday. Alrighty, guys, the comic book video now. Laters.